Okay, so we find ourselves in the shop today working on a Subaru 360 part. This here is the Subaru 360 van or Sambar air filter assembly. It's very rare. I shouldn't say it's very rare. It's rare for someone to have one. Most people, or most of them, get lost over time. People take them off when servicing the carburetor and they get lost. So they're hard to find, but if you do have one, if you're lucky enough to have one, you probably don't have an air filter for it. It's a weird triangular shape inside. See that? It's kind of kidney bean shaped. And the air filters themselves, the elements, are unobtainium. So what the club has figured out is these lawnmower filters here. These are Briggs & Stratton. See if I can focus in on that part number there. Oops, I got it upside down. It's a Briggs & Stratton 622751. And you'll need two of them. But you'll need to take the top off of one of them. When you put them together, which is what we're ultimately going to do, you want one large air filter. When they come with a metal cap on each end. And to rid that, you use your little Burns-O-Matic map gas, and you heat up the lid, it's still a little warm, until the glue just starts to catch fire. It'll smoke and fuss, but just when the glue starts to see a little flame, it'll fall right off. And once that falls off, you can take your other filter and silicone them together, like so. And you bring them over to your filter assembly, like this, and they go right in there. Something like that. It's almost a direct replacement. And the lid, of course, then goes on top. So there you go. There's your tip and trick for the day for Subaru 360 Sambar, or van, truck, with the factory air cleaner assembly. That's how you can actually make yourself an element. These run $6.99, $7 a piece, Amazon.com, and you'll need two of them. And again, that part number, zoom in on that. Whoa. Upside down. Sorry about that. 622751 Briggs & Stratton, made in the USA. So there you go, is a tip and trick for today on Subaru Sambar air filter assemblies. Just an added bonus here, if you think you're just going to do away with this stock assembly and go with the K&N, don't bother. You actually lose about 5 horsepower. There's something about the volume of this canister and the way that this intake runs up through the frame to give it nice cool air. It gives the van quite a bit more pep. Believe me, I've tried. I even have dyno runs to prove it. So there you go, your tip and trick for the day. Make your van run good, make it run like it should. You'll be very happy you did. Thanks for watching.